Hi everyone, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this lesson we are going to explore the blues on the piano. We are going to look at this iconic genre which has also influenced a ton of other genres. So if you're a piano player starting off, or if you're a piano player who's played a bit or explored a lot of other genres, you need to be able to play the blues. The blues is a very essential genre. It's something which has inspired everything we have in the field of contemporary music. We are going to do this lesson in a few parts. First of all, I'm going to share with you the chord progression, the general phrase structure. It's a very unique 12 bar form, so we need to learn that thoroughly. Then we are going to look at how to build the chords on the piano using inversions and using proper voice leading. Then I'm going to show you what the left hand is going to do with respect to this genre. I'm going to give you a go-to left hand rhythm which you'll find applicable to a lot of blues songs. Then I'm going to show you, obviously, the right hand. We can't leave out the right hand. The right hand is going to do an iconic rhythm called the Charleston rhythm, which I'm going to teach you in detail. And then we are going to put them together. We are going to get things done with our voice, with singing, which is very, very important if you're playing any music to be a better piano player. Because if you can accompany yourself, you can accompany pretty much anyone, right? And last but not least, you're going to learn a little bit of what I was doing in that intro video, where we are going to improvise and create a piano solo in our right hand while the left hand does its thing. And to do that, again, we are going to learn two iconic blues scales which have really made the genre shine for all the decades of the blues existence. So without any delay, we are going to get started right away. It'll be great if you can get a notebook. You'll need to write down a few things, and you're going to play along with me as I play and teach you stuff. I want you also to form it. So get your books, get your pianos, and we're going to get started now. So for playing the blues, we have a 12 bar blues progression, okay, which is also used in rock and roll and a few other genres. So I'm going to take it in the key of C major. You can do it on any scale. So let's build the chords on the C major scale, okay? So you have the one chord, which is C major, C, E, G, okay? Then you have the four chord, which is F major, F, A, C. Then you have the fifth chord, which is G major, G, B, D. So these are the three chords you're going to use for this exercise, and pretty much for playing blues, the form of blues, which is basically the 1, the 4 and the 5 chords built over this 12 bar progression. Okay, so it's going to be 1, 4 and 5. You also might want to get used to the shapes of each of these chords. So the 1, C major, can either be played this way or this way. These are the inversions. In other words, it's a 3-note chord, so you can jumble the notes as per your convenience or the sound you want, or also as you're playing the chords together, because the chords need to lead well, what we call as voice leading, and also, in simple words, be easier to play. So for example, if I'm on C major here, I would want to go to this version of F major, CFA, because it's easier to shift, isn't it? As opposed to doing C major and then jump all the way up to F major. So C, E, G, CFA, come back to C major, C, E, G, B, D, G, which is the G major chord. Or else I could start on the other inversion of C major, which is E, G, C, also called as the first inversion. So you do E, G, C, F, A, C, E, G, C, D, G, B, G major, okay? Or you could start with G, C, E, then A, C, F, G, C, E, G, B, D. Right, I'm singing you the notes so that you can also form it that way if things go wrong. Okay, so write down your inversions, connect your chords very well, and you want to use inversions because there's a lot going on with this genre. So you need to get all your foundational things under the belt before you get started, right? So that was about the chords. Now let's bring it into the chord progression. So the chord progression is a 12 bar chord progression. You have Roman 1, as we call it. Roman 1 means the first chord of the major scale. So we are using the 1, the 4 and the 5 chords. 1 is major, 4 is major, 5 is major. So all the major chords are used for blues, okay? So Roman 1. And the way I'm going to be playing this or demonstrating it is to actually play it over the pulse. 1, 2, three, four. So if this is the speed of my music, one, two, three, four. So I'll be playing, if I have to play C major for one bar, it'll be like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, second bar. Third bar, like this, okay? So one bar of any chord is going to be played as four counts in the right hand, and you hold the root note of the chord in the left hand. Okay, so let's do this over the entire 12 bar cycle, which is 1 1 1 1. That's the first line you see there. So 1 1 1 1 means you just play C major, but in some blues songs, they go to the 4 after the 1. So you get 1 4 1 1. Okay, so that's an alternative option. So let's get cracking with the chords. C major, first bar. C major, second bar. C major, third bar. C major, fourth bar. Okay, that's line one, and it's just one chord. If you'd like, at the second bar, you could go to the F major chord, which is C major, F major, and back to C major. Stay on. That adds a lot more sonic flavor. Okay, let's get that going again. Let's do only C major first. C major, second bar. C major, third bar, C major, fourth bar, and then the next line comes, which I'm going to share with you shortly. And also note, I'm playing the root of the chord in the left hand, or the name of the chord. Okay, so now moving to the second line. The second line contains the F major chord, which is this one, and then come back here. Okay, so the second line, if you see there, has 4, 4, 1, 1. So I'm starting my 1 like this, E, G, C. I'd recommend that you all do this. It's quite easy. E, G also trains you to get your inversions going, because we normally play C major like this. So start like this. So C major for that entire first line, which is 4 bars. Then the next line is F major for 2 bars, which will go F major, F major, and back to C major. Okay, C major twice. Let's do the second line again. F major, F major, and back to C major. Okay, and then moving to line number 3. Okay, there we finally have the 5 chord, or the G major chord. G major. I'm playing it as DGB. You can play it however you want, but I would prefer this. DGB. Only one bar of the G major. Then F major. Only one bar of the F major. And then back to C major. Okay. G major, F major, C major. Right? So G major. Let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And there you have it. That's the 12 bar form. So line 1, line 2, line 3. Each line has 4 bars each. Let's play it all together. I'm going to count it, and then we'll try and get to some singing and understand the phrase structure of the blues. Okay? Starting. 1. One again, one, one, and then the four comes, four again, and back to one, one again, and the last line, five, four, and one. Either you do one twice, or you can do one with a 5. You can do 1-5 at the end. So that'll be 5-0-4 and back to 1. Ba-da-ba, 5. Which takes you nicely back to the next 12 bar cycle, which lands on the 1. So these are the alternate options. At line 1, second bar, you can play the F chord instead of the C chord, or the 1 chord. And the last, very last bar, you can do the G chord or the 5 chord. So this is about the blues progression, and the way the blues is structured is it's structured in phrases. Okay, so we call the phrases traditionally as A, A prime, and B. Very poetic in nature, if you think about it. So A represents a sentence performed by the songwriter, which is something, right? For example, Well, I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. Okay, that's one line in the song, I'm tore down. And then A prime would essentially be the same melody and the same lyric with a slight difference in the harmony. Obviously, the chords are changing and maybe the melody will change a little bit, right? So, well, I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. That could be A. And A prime, well, I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. Could just do a little bit of variation, but the lyric will pretty much be the same. And then finally, you have the B at the end, which goes something like, well, I feel like this, where my baby can be found. So something very different, and different lyrics, and different melody. So that's why we say A, A prime, B. So if I do A, A prime, B with the chord progression, it works really great. And I would encourage you to sing as you play. It's a great way to enjoy the blues. Don't just play the piano. You need to sing. So let's do this song. I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. Well, I feel like this when my baby can't be found. Now, this is a genre which I quite like personally because even I can remember the lyrics and I'm really bad with lyrics. Right? So let's get cracking with this with me singing, and let's do the same hand ratio 1:4. C major, I'm holding like this. Come on. 1, 2, 3. Well, I'm tore down, almost level with the ground. Still on the 1. Oh, well, I'm tore down. Chord 4. Almost level with the ground. Back to 1. Twice. Well, I feel like this. 5. Well, my baby. 4. Can be found. Ending on 1. Okay? Let's do this once more without me doing the talking and the explanation. Just the singing. A 1. A 2. A 1. 2. 3. Oh, well, I'm tore down. Almost level with the ground. Well, I'm tore down. I'm almost level with the ground. Well, I feel like this. Oh, well, my baby can be found. One more time, please. Oh, well, I'm tore down. Let's take it slow. Almost level with the ground. Yeah. Oh, well, I'm tore down. I'm almost level with the ground, yeah. Turn around. Well, I feel like this. Well, my baby can be found. You can even do like a stop there. Well, I feel like this. Stop at the 4. Oh, well, my baby can be found. Where you highlight the vocalist of your band or the lick which the soloist is playing. In my case, I may not want to highlight much because I'm not the greatest singer. Anyway, so that's about playing the blues, the chord progression, the phrase structure, and also you need to sing a blues classic like I'm Tore Down or Sweet Home Chicago or Backwater Blues. These are all blues classics which you have to go through at some point in your career as an artist. Might as well do it now with me in this video. Right, everyone? So in the next part, we are going to look at what the left hand can do to make it sound absolutely bluesy and what the right hand can do to make it sound extremely bluesy, with two very, very tried and tested go-to iconic rhythm patterns or even chord patterns. The chords and the rhythm are going to sound like never before. So head over to part 2 and I will see you in the next video. Cheers.